We are moving towards the Manoj Kumar sir. He is from the InfluentNet and basically taking care. And you people, some of you may be aware about him to know his course about to the plagiarism and all these things. And he is basically taking care of all the thing in India, not only through the courses, but he is very. What I should say about to him. That let's move toward the Dr. Manoj sir. Are you available there? Please unmute your mic and video and over to you, sir. Manoj sir. And it will be great that if you, social media influencer, right, and share a number of the things on social media for the culture, for the education, and there are so many things that they have to share with you all. So, my dear friends, just welcome to the Manoj sir. Please, over to you.
Hello. Am I audible?
Yes, sir. Perfect. Very good afternoon.
Good afternoon, everybody. Dr. Sushil and other speakers. Am I audible now?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yeah, because I can't see anybody's face. All are on mute. Videos are on mute, except to Dr. Suresh Singh.
No. There is a former vice chancellor, sir. Is there?
Oh, he's vice chancellor. Sir, yes. Sirji, thank you very much for giving me an opportunity. It is nice to see you. I was listening to some of your sessions. And thank you for giving an opportunity by Chittara University. I could see you about 1:26 when I left in at 11:30. Now it is 1:02. The people are feeling hungry to leave. Another 1 hour, I will be talking. So let me go to my presentation. After all, I was enjoying the presentation by everybody. And there were a lot of queries which are directly related to the topic which are going to be talked today by me. I am Manoj Kumar, the senior scientist from InfluentNet Center, looking after three projects now, Shodh Ganga, which is a repository of theses. We have grown up to 3 lakh theses now. That is one of the maybe reason which prompted Dr. Sushil Kumarji to call me. The other project which I personally handle is that Shodh Shuddhi, under which we provide a plagiarism software. And which was, we were providing Urkun, but there is a surprise announcement today to all of you. Maybe you are the first person to listen to that surprise on plagiarism software, if all of you are. Can I just know a little bit from Dr. Sushil Kumar, because I was not there the introduction and introduction. All the people are from the same university, all are using the software called Urkun under plagiarism.
No. The audience are basically are from different universities.
Hello.
Yes.
Okay. Different universities. All are research scholar and PhD scholars, no?
And faculty also.
Yes, because the questions which came on. So those who are listening to me for the first time, hi to all of you. Listening to a second or third time, maybe I will have some surprises for you, as you always keen to learn something from InfluentNet Center. And I can see three digit here. I hope when I stop the presentation at 2 o'clock, we still will have the three digit percentage participants inside. Let me share the screen directly. What will be the topic of discussion today? Is the screen visible?
Yes, sir.
I hope it is National Seminar on Publishing and Research Ethics. The first portion is completed by two faculty. For research ethics, there were references by the faculty for the research ethics as well. The ethics in publication, ethics in including author, ethics in multiple author, the rules, all these were discussing. And I was listening to you, though I was doing my job. And for me also, it is lunchtime. So I respect your time for spending at this time between 1 to 2, where everyone enjoys lunch. So Chitkara University is located in Punjab?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, in Chandigarh. So we have quickly gone through that how you were performing in the lockdown period. So I will just start from where it is. This 1 hour topic will be related, though you have told about plagiarism as a word. It will not be just plagiarism, because plagiarism cannot be stopped by just one tool. It's very difficult. There are multiple issues to be handled by universities, which altogether implemented a mechanism, then only the plagiarism issues will come down. A single software cannot stop it. That's why this talk is containing a lot of things. What UGC was doing, what MHRD is doing, what InfliNet is doing currently under the guidance of both UGC and InfliNet Center. And I will be also referring to some of the landmark notification issued by UGC. And all these projects are related to some of the notification, which is mandatory in nature, to be followed by all universities in the country. So you can see from all this, this is what intently I want to talk about. But 1 hour is a very less time, you know. We conducted a more training program for this. In fact, InfliNet is also conducting a paid program for this. In March, April 6th onwards, we have a online paid program which is coming to cover all these in details for 5 days. So we intend to cover in 5 days, which is very intensive training program in InfliNet that is given to this. And I should also tell that I am taking a kind of challenge to put all topic together in 1 hour. That can be extended up to 40 hours. That is my challenge and your challenge also as a participant. So 40 hours Swayam MOOC course on research ethics, I am trying to give you in 1 hour time. So whatever is missing you. So I will start with that, how Punjab is doing, as in Chitkara is in Punjab University, where you can, all these universities are personally some hidden agenda for every universities in conducting this program. What is the hidden agenda? Hidden agenda is good for education and higher education. Hidden agenda to improve quality and come up in top of the other universities. So your university should come up in the first in the state, then go in that. And I will not compare your university right now, but I'm giving a picture of that. How, when we try to did an analysis of Punjab in the year during lockdown, August 2020 and September, we find that there are 17 universities are there and 19 has signed with us, including your university. So compliment to your university for coming forward for that. That is the reason you contacted me, I know. But there are still 2% university there have not signed but contributing. But 13 universities, if they are your neighboring university, I request you that they have to follow UGC notification, which is issued in the year 2009. So that we understand research ethics is taken as a serious measure in the institute. The awareness is one of the subset of that sensitizing seminar conducting. That's why Vice Chancellor himself is sitting there. It is the responsibility of institution. Looking from Vice Chancellor to research scholar has to follow, including PG student. So there are universities still from Punjab which signed but not contributing. 13 are there, we are looking forward. So if they are your neighboring universities, insist them that be part of it. And if you look at, we have seen about 40,000 documents from Punjab itself has been submitted into plagiarism check. So that's also a good number as far as that. But there are still 4 universities, they have not used our software. Maybe they are using their own, but not informed us. So this is the status of that. So there are 4 projects which are relatively important for research ethics, and I am talking. When you compromise ethics, what is going to happen? What is the compromising of ethics in research? There could be few issues. One, you will try to misconduct in the, you will try to fabricate the data. You will conduct the writing of somebody. You will take somebody's content and write. As you mentioned that including an author from a foreign country, you have discussed so much. That means taking consent from somebody, that is the compromise which is happening. And I have the figure which I have till like Shodh Shuddhi for 74,000 documents are submitted by 32 universities from Punjab now. That's a good number. And 70 and Shodh Ganga about 4,200 theses are submitted as on date. Now, what is Shodh Ganga when I am mentioning and why it is related to research ethics? UGC was discussing about how to reduce plagiarism. So they felt that even if we are giving tool or anything, UGC cannot have a cross check unless the research public as a thesis should be uploaded. So UGC decided to upload the full text thesis from 2009 onwards. You might have received the notification, which I will show you right now, where one clause says that you have to upload the thesis into Shodh Ganga if it is getting awarded. That is the latest news. In 2009, it is told within 30 days. You are to. So university started, we started signing an MOU because sometimes no university question, what is your right? We are, our right is as per notification, we are signing. That is the MOU you sign with us. And we take the responsibility of hosting it. So we have over 3 lakh full text theses from 475 universities, where we have 570 universities signed. Some of them are pretty new central universities. Some of them are in either not yet started awarding PhD theses. So that's why there's a difference in the number. But we have universities which have not signed, but still contributing 60 universities. And that is what is Shodh Ganga. So ladies and gentlemen, those who are watching me on research, I think, please keep the name, which you already know. Sometimes when you write to me, the spelling goes wrong. It is not S-O-D-H. It is S-H-O-D-H. Two H is there in Shodh, which is denote the full text digital contribution thesis. How this can stop plagiarism? My topic is plagiarism and I'm talking about Shodh Ganga. Why? Because your thesis, once it is awarded, it will come to Shodh Ganga repository. Anybody from anywhere, because it's an open access repository, they can definitely check your thesis even after it is awarded. So we have a dozen incidents where the PhD has been challenged after submission, after award, after submitting into Shodh Ganga. That means we have 1 dozen PhD thesis is to be withdrawn from the repository where there was a plagiarism challenge. So you have to be very careful, ladies and gentlemen, if you are doing research, your research is going to be in open access repository like Shodh Ganga as per the national policy. UGC's policy, UGC is the apex body of government of India, decide the policy, they have decided soft copy should be uploaded. So you don't have any other option on that. And now UGC is also insisting us, why don't you start putting a repository where what is going on also to be there? What is awarded is Shodh Ganga. That is what is Shodh Gangotri, second one. So these two projects are interlinked. One is synopsis or research proposal. The other is full text repository. And right now 8,000 plus synopsis are supposed. So those who are research scholars are listening to me now, kindly send me 1-page abstract or extended abstract or synopsis or your research proposal submitted into your university into Shodh Gangotri. When you complete your PhD, this will be taken to Shodh Ganga with your full text thesis. So this is responsibility of university coordinator as well. So Sushir Kumar ji, along with Shodh Ganga, please promote Shodh Gangotri as well. So that you are, I can tell that Chitkara University, all PhD researcher, I think it is about 80, all of them will be available in Shodh Gangotri. I would say happy. So my one hour can be compensated by giving that synopsis into. And I also expect all your PhD thesis which is pending, who should be uploaded into this. I don't know how many are there right now, 70, 79? I think I figure there. Okay, then Shodh Shuddhi. Shuddhi means, you know, Ganga is the river flowing with the history and civilization of Indian culture. And Shodh Ganga denotes the cities. And Shodh Shuddhi, Shuddhi in our Devanagari language, any script, Shuddhi means cleaning. So we gave this project name for providing plagiarism software. So today, I cannot tell today, till 14th March, we were giving a software called Urkun. How many of you have noticed it is changed? Can I get some questions in? Is it possible to put the questions in chat box by somebody? Otherwise, it's okay. So that it will become interactive. So almost 1 lakh people, that is 100,000 users are using the software under Infliminate scheme now. And Chipkara University is one among them. That's why he was very keen to have a talk where we, the provider, to talk to that. But what is the software we were using, Sushilji?
Both are, we are using Turnitin and Orkund also.
Okay, Turnitin and Urkund. The Urkund name is changed today.
Hmm.
Today, if you are looking at our website, you will see original.
Okay.
That's what I told. I will be having a happy news for you.
Thank you.
Urkund has taken over by Urkund, a company called Urkund. They have taken two plagiarism detection software, PlagScan and Urkund together, and named as original. Original means our original combined, like breakfast and lunch you are combining, meaning brunch. Our original is combining it as original, and today you will see original only, not Urkund, but you will see all the features. So why I am glad to share it, when two software vendors are joining, the backend database of both will merge together and the user is getting more results. Correct, no?
Correct.
And wait, we are not far behind. Turnitin will be merged with the same thing.
Ah, great.
Don't take it as an official statement. I'm telling, the merging and acquisition is going to such a way that you cannot even imagine. Sometimes today, tomorrow, it will happen. Maybe after 3 months or 5 months, Turnitin may also take over this. And it's a big company now. So this is what is happening. So using a software, talking about a software is not very important. What is important? Talking about the research ethics. So I would be more happy to concentrate on research ethics than the software tool. Tool will get changed. Interface will get changed. Sushil Kumarji has personally been trained to use Urkund, if I am correct, but that interface is going to change. So what is the new interface? You have to use it, but the ethics remains same. That's what. And we also have other project which is similar to our name, Shodh Sindhu, but this is nothing to do with the research. This is Resolver. They provide electronic journal to research scholar, and all the university can subscribe to that. Some of them are paid subscription on a negotiated rate, I should say. Some of them university can themselves buy it. We provide it depending upon the fund we receive from MHRD. That's all. Now, this is what is the scenario of Chitkara University, Punjab, 99 theses. So why don't you make it the magical number of 100 by uploading one more thesis?
Definitely, sir.
100 full-test PhD theses have been submitted by Chitkara University, Punjab. So congratulations. You are one among the university. We have presence in this, but we are happy when you are telling this is our 100%. So in NAC and a similar kind of accreditation, any ranking, you can tell we are 100% digitalized on CCs. To say that, one PCs of thesis also should not be missed. You mentioned 100% theses are digitized and put on Shodh Ganga by our university, not like 99 theses.
Definitely.
So that should be. Now I talked about two notification. Hopefully, you know the notification issued in 2009 inside top corner. Let me see whether I can use some tools on this. This is which one? This is. Okay, I cannot annotate on it now. This is Zoom meeting. Zoom meeting annotation is not possible. Only you can. Can you see my browser?
No, this time.
Browser? No. Okay, and it's okay. 2009 is left side, and 2009 this is amended. 2016, This is regarding the first concept of plagiarism and research ethics was told in this. This regulation is very important for PhD supervisor, dean, and vice chancellor, because you are following this notification in letter and spirit, where one of the clause says that you have to submit a copy into Infliminate Center. The old notification within 30 days, new notification day, even after award and issuing a provisional certificate, you can upload so that people see it and read it and challenge the university. Yes, nothing is there. After that, when it is convocation is done, it is awarded, then we make it publicly available. This is the concept now. UGC is one step ahead now, beyond everybody's thought. That's why it is not completed PhD. Even if it is provisionally awarded, then also you should upload. That is what the second notification says. Okay. And 2018 one notification came. Any idea what was the extraordinary notification issued by 2018?
No ideas.
That is the landmark notification of regarding plagiarism. The notification is named as Promotion of Academic Integrity and Prevention of Plagiarism in the country, history of our post-independence. First time the country given an extraordinary notification by UGC to deal with plagiarism. Before that, there was no mention about it. So as per this notification, you should have for proper mechanism, you should have two level committee, departmental integrity, academic integrity panel, institutional academic integrity panel in the university part of it. That is the second notification, which I have not included here. I will talk about. So I just tell you that kindly, we are touching now 2-3 lakhs thesis, 2.9. It was 4 months back. Now it is 2.99, and you can also see how to cite. Citation is an issue. When you are going into a chapter, you get a long URL, but nowadays if you are going to chapter, we have resolved this technical issue. The citation details will pop up. You can download in BibTeX and use it on any of your software you are using, like MS Word, or you are using any software, Mentally, Zotero. You can use that reference, ResearchGate, Google Scholar. You can use the same BibTeX for your citation. Okay. So this is about the statistic. Exactly how many are there? 2,99,999. Have you seen the magical number there? Our Shodhganga team plays with a number all the time. Now you will see 3 lakhs. It will be all 9,999, and we will make it 3 lakhs immediately on a particular rate, so that we want to somebody to launch it. So all those who are visiting, the 3 lakh PhD theses are free, open access for you. No registration required. And if you are a supervisor, tell your students to download at least 20 theses in the topic reading in the initial 10 days. So that's why Shodhganga is important for research. And if you look at that, how it is going, in January it is 2.91. Despite all these issues, within 3 months, I should say 2.5 months, 8,000 theses are added. And MHRD also has circulated a letter to all CFTIs, including IIM, IIT, NITs, to join this project. And Shodh Gangotri, we have 8,000 synopsis, exact number 8,131 as on date yesterday. And if you have MRP, PDF, Emirate Fellowship, all this under any project, major research project of UGC, Emirate, that report also you can give it to us. We upload Shodh Gangotri, we give you a link so that you can mention in your biodata, or you can even write to UGC what settlement I have uploaded. And if this link is there, UGC will never settle your account. Now coming to research ethics part, we have given a name called Shodh Shuddhi, and the Honorable Minister of HRD, earlier it was HRD, now it is Minister of Education, she has launched it in September 21st, because notification come in 18, we made it, we told we should give a project, some project tip over, and 1,040 universities are giving it free of cost. So who are the beneficiaries? The beneficiaries are faculty members, research supervisors, and research scholars. Right now, we are not giving to PG students and undergraduate students. That because we have you look at the number, how many documents submitted in a year? 10 lakh document, despite our loan. So we have an agreement with this Urkund for 10 lakh document per annum. And we have crossed it.
More than 81,000.
That means next 1 year, we may having 13 lakhs documents. Now we are trying to have an agreement for like that. We have 2 years agreement now with the software. And software is growing day by day, which I already told. The software which we have not heard before, Urkund. Now, this has been discussed. The software has entered into the market of United States now. That's why merging we are expecting. But it was in Europe. Those who went for United States for study, they know only Turnitin. Those who are from Europe, they will be knowing about Urkund as well. Those who have completed education recently only I'm talking, because Urkund is not a very old software. So now all the software is coming in dialogue so that they will feel that, okay, what software should be there. And the Influent is very keen to take the best software in an economical manner to give it to university. Primary issue while focusing any software, we also have the economic status of our country while deciding a software. So with all merit, with the 70 parameter, we have selected the software and given to you. And you can see that how per month, how many documents are submitting into Urkund. If any university inside this group who have not started using it, my humble request, contact Sushil on WhatsApp and start trying to use. And today you will see login into Urkund. Tomorrow you will see login into original. So I have the reason. So a recent screenshot also. So this is how the thesis repository has gone in the last year. We have a very huge challenge, I should say, during the first lockdown month. All academic institution closed. Theses were not coming. And usage also went down. March it was 7,000 and in April it is 800. Then 90% PhD did not come. Now gradually it has started, still it has not reached to that level because all institutes are still closed and everything is opening online only. Submissions are either not up. So this is the January to December thesis upload statistics. And here we have included login in Urkund, now renamed as original. It has not come. Yes, you opened Urkund. This our shows to this has not come yet. Today evening only we'll update. So this is the approved slide which I have taken, which will be changed today evening. So you are listening to the latest of me, I should say. And when you are taking, we are trying to correct wherever Urkund is named as original. Okay. Now, this is what Urkund is changed to original from 15th March. And today is 17th, you know. Yeah. They changed only 15th. So today is 17th. So that's why everybody may not be knowing it. Now I request all of the faculty, go and give talk to the nearest institution, talk on original. It is same as Urkund, no difference. So if you go to original screen, it will show like this, four screen. The first part is for users. The second part is for admin, university administrator. Now, lot of new features are there. You can delete a document now. We can delete a document from the repository, which was not there earlier. And if you still want to use Urkund, the last one, access to old web inbox. This is for Urkund. They have not mentioned Urkund because name is changed. But we are telling this is Urkund interface, old one. So you can log in 2 ways. One is use this and use the first one. And use the same username and password. There is no change. Only change if you have already submitted 100 document earlier, that you will not get in the first 15 onwards, the dashboard is blank. If you want old one, log in here and still it is available. So there is not much change except interface change. Beautiful interface has come now. You will like it. And when you click on the login, user login, web login, it will show you two kind of login. One is this, second. And we have to use the second one. The first one is if you are part of, that is a scope for your university. If VCs, vice chancellor and senior members are still listening, I would like to mention that you can install your IDP provider, means show the Shibboleth based access control. If you are computer scientist and users are using LDAP server, you create the LDAP server, we will give you an identity provider and we will give our identity. That is what is called Shibboleth Infed. Inflimate call it as Infed. So we have about 100 institutions which have already created Infed. So if you have Infed, you don't need this login. You can go here, select the institution, use your institute username and password, and you can log in. Is it a new feature or not?
Yeah.
But you need to have Shibboleth installed in your university for all the faculty, which has to be integrated with the existing policy of your LDAP server. Tell your computer scientist to get in touch with us. We will help them. Otherwise, use the old username and password. Use it. You can get it. And you can even user login. You can change the password. Everything is there still. You can change your old password. And submit a document. If you submit, it will up. I told webinar.pdf for a sample check from PDS Tech. And it will show you. It is 100% plagiarized because I have taken it from somewhere. So it shows the report 100%. You will get this matching test, warning, original. All this looks similar. It will be in inbox. I mentioned there is a scope. Can you see the create document or upload document here in the left side in original? That means you can delete a document. It will go to bin. Then Urkund will not check into that document next time. So if you submit a document, next time when you modify and again submit it, Urkund will show it is already there, 90% similarity. That can be avoided now. One of the technical challenge we solved. Okay. And look at the report. It comes as very interesting now. Urkundka report, colored one. If you take one page, it will show you which paragraph is copied by color. So color image of the similarity is displayed on that. So this is how it will appear. If you look at warning, the document portion has some kind of manipulation done. That is this blue color. And matching test, almost 100%. From where it will show which document. So there are 73 words, small document which is copied. So it shows that matching test 100%. But your case, it will be different. Different link will come. So that's about research ethics onto this. I have almost finished my time on the introduction of 40 minutes. And I have another 20 minutes to quickly go through the philosophical talk on ethics, if you are interested. This time I took a tool first because there was a change in the tool. Sushilji, any question till so far?
This time as such, there is no question, but my question will come after watching some more thing, because there are so many things that run in my mind related to the publishing, related to the ethics, and make these things popular among the society. So now one thing is going in my mind that is related to the original promotion, frankly speaking, at this platform. So in evening, I will create a video and that I will share with other friends, those who basically could not watch these important thing. So I will share that thing. And in addition to it, sir, personally, I will share with you PPT and I will show a thing. So you could get some more insight related to the facts.
Yeah, definitely. Just 1 minute. I think I have missed the screen now.
Yeah, someone basically raising the hand. I don't know.
We'll take two questions because I don't want to be very monotonous. Not.
Yeah,
that will be stop great. Share and I take the question. Again, I'll go back to that. Let me see chat. There are some questions. Mr. Priya Raina has asked a private question to me.
Yeah.
Won't uploading synopsis and synopsis on Shodganga lead to plagiarism problem later? when we want to publish it later as paper or book, even after adding references of the uploaded work, I have to rephrase the article significantly so as to bring down the level of plagiarism below 20%. What is the solution to this problem? In nutshell, the question came to me. Dr. Priya Raina, your question is very valid. Once you put it in Shodh Ganga, your full text thesis or synopsis, if you are using it in some publication, the same text, then it will show as plagiarism. So what is the best method is, while sending the article for publishing, you can mention that this is part of your research which is already published as per the national policy in a repository. So the plagiarism people can exclude Shodh Ganga in testing if they are convinced that you, that is your responsibility to convince. And the other method, easiest method, through Vice Chancellor Register to us to put an embargo period. Your article will be published in 6 months time. So we will not put your article, PhD thesis publicly for 6 months till your paper is getting published. That is the easiest method. But VC and Register should certify, not the university coordinator. Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you so much, sir.
Yeah. Any other question? I don't have any questions.
Yeah, it will be great if you will ask the question. Aarti. Yeah.
Good afternoon, sir. This is Aarti Rana from Architecture, and I'm research scholar in urban design. So my question is, if I'm following any method which is being used by any author in European context, and I'm using the same method in Indian context, will that method also come under plagiarism? Because the methodologies remain somehow similar.
Plagiarism in the right context is copying of text. That means similarity of text.
Okay.
So if you are copying somebody's paragraph as it is plagiarism. If you are copying somebody's idea and writing yourself, if the author challenges, it is plagiarism. Else you have to give a reference to that. Otherwise also you have to give. Idea cannot be copied unless you cite the original man. And in the world, every research scholar, 99% of research scholar agree to share their content when you cite them. The only benefit what we are getting is a citation. So the more people cite, the more important is your work. So if you ask to copy methodology, if you feel citation is enough, you have to acknowledge him. Then cite it properly, acknowledge it properly, give the credit to the contributor, use it. If you still having doubt, this man or the researcher in the country, outside country, can send them a mail mentioning that what you want to do with that content.
Yes.
Get a permission from that.
All right, sir. Thank you so much, sir.
Yeah.
Yeah, this will be a great idea if you ask directly to the person if that methodology is standard and given by the researcher or that person, and acknowledge properly.
Okay.
That's good, and I think good questions are coming. I think more questions will be there, and I'm very happy that people are listening to me also.
Dr. Srivastav, have you asked some question? Can you illustrate about citation index? Dr. Arun Srivastav.
Dr. Arun Srivastav, am I waiting for you?
No problem, sir. Carry on.
Otherwise, can I go ahead?
Yes.
I have spent about 5 minutes for question and answer in between. Let us look at misconduct and unethical practices. Ladies and gentlemen, is there any possibility of taking a photo like this in your state now? I am not very sure. I know you cannot answer me directly unless I unmute this. Okay. Now, this picture becomes a kind of impossible in India for last 1 year. Students sitting shoulder to shoulder, teacher standing very close to that and studying in a classroom as usual. and we are going more on online mode, including research is already online, but even teaching at the lower class and school classes are going to be online, which we never predicted 2 years back. The entire IT community, the IT industry, the IT professional, the computer scientists, and the policy makers of the nation was telling, we have to go online. But with online classes will not give you the right kind of feel of a class, we were told. But thanks to this virus, it made us to think differently. Otherwise, I had no thanks to them. It's a deadly virus. Okay, now this scenario becomes, this scene becomes, and a school like this becomes impossible. We have to gradually, some of the states it has started, but still in a very limited way. Now, one question I will ask you that, since you are taking a lot of content online, the content you are taking from internet and all other sources, how do you feel about this statement? I made a statement, internet has made it easier for everyone to plagiarize. I put a search engine logo also there. Am I right or not?
Yes.
So I know that I cannot get an answer from you. Some of you will tell that, yes, you are right. Internet has made it easier for everyone to plagiarize. And I will put a reverse of this statement, just opposite, diagonally opposite of this statement. Internet has made it difficult for everyone to plagiarize. How many agree with me? The opposite of the statement. Now, you are thinking in two ways now. One is internet has made it easy. The other one is internet has made it difficult for everyone to plagiarize. Two diagonally opposite statements. Which one you stand for as a researcher and supervisor? You feel it is a tough question. Some of you are answering first, some of you are answering second. How many of you have answered both are correct? Very surprisingly, it's called a paradox. Two different opposite statements, you have to stand with both statements. Both are true. So, Harmeet Kansi has replied me to privately that both are correct. And in this context, both are correct. Why? Because taking content is very easy from internet. That's why plagiarism is made easy. But it is difficult because if you take content from online, anybody can take the same content and check it. The same line, if somebody put it in Google, in a search engine, which is very popular now, it will show you that, yes, the content is already available. So checking for plagiarism is very easy for anybody. You don't need any tool. Line by line, put it in Google and find it out. This is how intelligent faculty members see. If a paper is submitted by somebody, your research scholar, he will randomly pick up some line from the his test and put it in Google and see whether it is copied or not. Even faculty doesn't need, they do not require, faculty members do not require that skill because they know the language of the research scholar. The moment they find that the research scholar is writing beautiful English than what is expected from them, you understand it is copied or somebody helped, maybe ghostwriting. So it is easier also to find out plagiarism when it is taken from. So both way it is correct, as you mentioned. Thank you. And this is another issue that now every institute, PG level especially, I have seen, there is group assignment. Any group assignment you are giving, there will be a group called gang. One will be very smart to do the job. Others will be enjoying. But ultimately, all of them will submit same assignment. Even in Indian university, one assignment for a group is accepted. That means a man who has not contributed anything or a girl who has not contributed anything in the sessional also will get the same mark. So there should be some check to see that whether it is correct or not. That is one. Why people are doing this? Because they want to get grade, A plus, or they want a good mark. For PhD, it is degree. For MPhil, it is degree. Why faculty member plagiarize? Because more publication, more chance for promotion. API score, performance format, all that now. which talks about faculty member as a researcher who publish. So this is one of the criteria for promotion. So A plus is a symbolic representation of all this: promotion, career, higher post, HOD post, principal's post, even vice chancellor post. The more publication and H index you have, the more chances of getting the post. So that's why some people tend to have more publication, whatever way possible. That whatever way become the copying from somebody or adding as an author to somebody who is a good publisher. But you don't know whether the person is copying content and putting your name. So this is happening with lot of examples are there. I have put a photograph here. If you are ethically not correct, we will tend to do all this. So I don't know what you call this man in the photograph in your area. But generally, these kind of photographs are shown a culprit. So we'll talk about it later. So simply, without defining plagiarism, it will not be correct to finish my talk. It's an act of presenting another works or idea. So if I put a full stop here after idea, whether it is plagiarism, plagiarism is an act of presenting another's work or idea. Full stop. Is it plagiarism? Last three words I did not read it out. The act of presenting another's work or idea, is it plagiarism?
Yes.
It is not. Act of presenting another's work and idea is permitted in research. But what is not permitted? The last three words. As you are on. That is not permitted. That's a difference. So if you know the difference, you are clearly very clear about plagiarism. That's why. See, this picture is not mine. This definition is not mine. So I put it here. You understand. Not created by Manoj. I put the link there. This. So if I put the link and reference to somebody cited in my research, that man cannot be treated as plagiarism. But what extent you can take such content? That is the question. That's why I ask you, read the notification issued by UGC in the year 2018. Very recent notification. There is an amendment came. There is an important notice came during lockdown in April 20 from UGC, which mentioned about self-plagiarism. If I publish an article, the second article I take 80% of my first article content and add a 20% extra and publish it. Is it possible or not? That is treated as self-plagiarism. There is a way to do it. That important notice, then you will understand. You cannot have content published with the two publisher the same content. So act of presenting another's work and ideas your own is what is plagiarism. And another lot of definition you will see. This is another act of stealing someone else's work, attempting to pass it off. Here also that focus is on that, pass it off as your own. And this can be applied to anything. Anything means what are the anything? In UGC notification, this is noted as scripts. Generally in presentation, I use a writing pad and write all that here. Here I cannot annotate it. So the anything means what? So let us name the anything here. Anything can be your PhD thesis. Anything can be your MPhil dissertation. Anything can be your assignment. Anything can be your MRP project reports. Anything can be an article published with any journal. Anything can be lecture note, or anything can be photograph, paper, song, interview, whatever it is. If it is belonging to somebody, even ideas, the last word you see, how idea is plagiarized. If somebody has mentioned an idea, you are working on it, you have to acknowledge that man before you start taking that. So that is what is plagiarism. Now, the question came. I was very eager to see. So many questions came. What is authorship, how author can be changed, how author can be act, where can I should be first author or second author. Ladies and gentlemen, this is a global phenomenon. India, it's a national phenomenon. The first paper research scholar write generally guide's name will put it as the first author. Many places it is like that. And it may be because of fear, or it can be because of the affinity towards your supervisor, rather your hardened respect or love for your faculty. I work for the paper, but first author is faculty. Second author is the original author. Such cases, it is always who works more should be the first author. Nowadays, I see that only the scholar is the first author. Faculty members are coming as the second. Supervisors are the second or third author. So that's why originality is what is important for any paper. What is mean by paper? Paper can be journal article, thesis, PhD, MPhil dissertation, and whatever you are mentioning, it comes into that category paper. So what is original written by the author is what makes the paper important. That is what is the quality of the paper. You send it to any reviewer, editor, they will look for this. So the first one is more important. And the last but one is the most important, currency of references. As far as research ethics is concerned, these two things has to be taken care. How to cite, where to cite, and what are the citation styles to be used, and how much you can cite. This is to be addressed while writing a paper, if you are taking, then only originality. And UGC notification tell there are core areas and non-core area. Non-core area only you can take content. Core area, zero tolerance for plagiarism. Zero tolerance for plagiarism in core area. What is core area? Core area is recommendation. Core area is abstract. Core area is future direction. Core area is conclusion. All this area, you cannot have any plagiarized content. Obviously, when I write the conclusion, how can I take somebody's content and tell that this man told, that's why I'm concluding? No, then you are not done with your research. So conclusion and future direction, like generally the last chapter should have 0% plagiarism. One chapter will have more plagiarism. Which chapter will have more plagiarized content, more similarity? Review of literature, because you are taking somebody's content and reviewing it. So that is possible to have more, but you should have citation for each and every article you are citing. And then research methodology, clarity of writings, whether logical progression of argument is there, currency. This is not our job as far as quality. That is job of the supervisor and the expert who evaluate it. Leave to them or the reviewer and editor. We are on focus on how much originality is there for the paper and whether you are cited properly or not. That is what is research ethics. And generally how papers are made? Papers are made like this, sitting on a lot of books, articles, referring a lot of articles online, maybe from Ishodh Sindhu, Endlist, Taylor and Francis, Elsevier, Emerald, Wiley, Gestor, any publisher, American Chemical Extract, CAS, CM Online. All this, you go refer, read, understand, paraphrase, put it for listener and write an article. But sometimes this happens. What is this? You go to 3 sources, 4 sources, multiple sources. Take one portion. In picture, it is from one area, but as a researcher, you can take from a different area. So you know computer technology, how to take content from a paper. What are the key combinations? Generally, when I am interacting online, no? So that's why I like to interact more on physical mode, so that I can get your answer. I am looking forward to visit Chitkara University and your faculty member on a day. All this we will discuss in person and get your comments on that. You use Control C, Control V. One is copy, other is paste. So that way we can make paper. That absolutely not permitted. You can use with the computer for learning, sure, for taking content, for referring, but it has to be paraphrased. And Control C, Control V. And what is not permitted? Control A, Control C, Control V is not permitted. What is Control A? Select all, copy all, paste all is not permitted. Control C and Control V you can use. If you are using a quotation, I do suggest use Control C, Control V. Don't change a single word inside, but it should be in quotation. So you can have quotation everything as per UGC notification. 10% is the last. 10% is the maximum possible similarity content which can appear in a paper or thesis. Somebody told 20%. No, madam, 20% journal accept. Some of the journal likes 25, some of the journal 15, 20. But as per UGC notification, it has to be 5%. 10%. Below 10 is treated as minor, no penalty. If it is copied and published, and anybody point out there is more than 10%, there are different penalty levels mentioned by UGC. 10 to 40, there is penalty. 40 to 60, there are penalty. 60 and above, up to 100. Severe in nature. Where research scholar registration will be cancelled even in first instance if it is more than 60%. If faculty means they have to withdraw the script, increment will be cut, they will be demoted, they will not be allowed to guide students for 3 years. Heavy penalty. And that your name will appear everywhere. You are a plagiarist. So say no to plagiarism. If you go to definition, you will understand what are the other possibility. Here, commit literary theft. So it is treated as theft by the online media. Theft is a crime. Crime is a punishable act. The different consequences are mentioned in UGC notification. Please go and read it. I don't have time to discuss it in detail. I have taken 1 hour session only on UGC notification. Why people plagiarize? Few reasons. Lack of knowledge, fear of failure, pressure to publish, competition, laziness, lack of enforcement. Sometimes planning to influence others. So plagiarism happens when you are taking somebody's exact words or idea without quotation. Words when you are taking, quotation is must. Idea when you are taking, citation is must. Or rearranging to get away from the software. That is also plagiarism. If anybody not complained to the committee will go through the original document, whether you changed the doc or not. The essence of the document is reflected as the same as the original document. You are a plagiarist. There are 4 types of plagiarism. Complete plagiarism, that is copy-paste, select all, copy all, paste all. Copy paste, Control P, Control C, Control V. You can do it when you cite it, use it as quotation. Word switch is treated as another. Self plagiarism. There are so many ways now plagiarism. Ghost writing is there. You don't know subject, so give somebody to write it. And software cannot catch it. But it is a misconduct in research. So these are some of the things. Self plagiarism, please read the notification issued. This is the extraordinary notification in 2018, I told. In addition to that, December 20th, there is a important notice issued by UGC of self-plagiarism. So for self-plagiarism, read that. I have written only one line. When you are previously only work, only if you are using without referring it properly, it is treated as self-plagiarism. But notice says so many things about it. So there are softwares available to detect it. Manual detection is very impossible. Computer detection is what is possible. So we provide software. There are 2 software from India, Check for Plagiarism, Drillbit. Some universities are using. UniCheck is already taken by Urkund. PlaxScan, which was mentioned, already taken by Urkund. Urkund is named as originality now, and the others also were start wavering. There is some another called Fipin. So I will only suggest this Urkund is here because the slide is prepared for today, few days back. But this should be original. If I meant to original, you will all surprise. What is this software? Which is this software? So Urkund is renamed as original now. So say not to plagiarism, enjoy research. These are the ways to avoid plagiarism. One way is to avoid plagiarism, read something, put your own words. Or another, take content if you feel essential and give credit to the other. A quotation is one way of it. And every beginning of every paragraph itself or sentence itself, you tell that what come next is not your idea, it is someone else's idea. So summarize like that. Even if you are taking somebody's word and putting your own words, but tell that this is what is told by this man. So learning about research ethics will not make you a good researcher. You have to do your own work. If I don't work, I don't get PhD. Keep careful track of your source. Use any reference management tool like Mentally, Zotero, etc. Understand what you have written. Acknowledge everybody. And this is the best slide. Stop my presentation today. Time is over. Avoid plagiarism. If you take a photograph of this and keep it in your research table, that is more than enough. Every time look at this, attribute reference. If you are reading, attribute. Describe all sorts of information which are related to your research and give acknowledgement wherever is possible. You can put it as simple acknowledgement. You can put it in footnote if the citation style says so. You can put it in bibliography. You can put it as a citation, not in reference. Use any standard citation style like APA, MLA, IEEE Online, Vancouver, and paraphrase the original attribute work. But if you are taking extensive quotation methodology or whatever from another person, obtain permission from the publisher. I remember the question asked here. If you want to use, obtain permission. Avoid self-plagiarism again by obtaining publisher. Even if you have published your own article, you want to include some of the portion, but take permission if it is major. And for drawing, etc., this is important. With that, I end up telling that there are punishment. You may lose your research social status and academic status if you are a plagiarist. You have seen vice chancellor photo appearing in newspaper in color for the challenge of plagiarism. You have seen the very senior government positions, such as director general, advisor to so and so, all comes under plagiarism challenge. You have seen the institute name in plagiarism, like even IIM's names have appeared, IIT's name has appeared in plagiarism. So forget about the simple private university like ours. If it is appearing, chance of research funding, that will be stopped. More than that, it's a professional stream. The professional stature is being questioned. Half a dozen vice chancellor lost the job only due to plagiarism. Director general of a very important institutions is asked by the cabinet to put his paper down because one of the report he prepared had plagiarism. So there are other things on this. So these are appearing in the paper. I have removed some of them. Research scholar will lose plagiarism. So it shakes academic integrity. University names are appearing as plagiarists. Some of the cases are there. So in global scenario, even if you copy song lyrics, this man paid $400 billion for plagiarism, John Bon Jovi Bean. The heartthrob of young generation. Justin Bieber has been challenged for an MTV song, plagiarism. So I just include this film was accused, Padman was accused of plagiarism, where this was settled by the producer by giving money. In institute that happened, but in academic you can't settle with money, because in film movie it will happen, because institute takes it as once it is done, it is done. It's a crime forever. You have to face the punishment. So UGC has come out with this. They have put the draft earlier. After that they have put following some of the standards available in US, UK and China. Here, the institution is responsible. If anybody plagiarizes in Chitkara University, nation is not responsible now. Who is responsible? Chitkara University, the supervisor and the research scholar. So that's all. UGC policy has have this academic integrity panel to look onto that. So there are certain things which can exclude while writing. That is quoted work produced with not necessary permission, attribution, citation. Reference, bibliography, table of contents, preface, acknowledgement. You can copy. But I am sure acknowledgement you will not copy because you cannot put someone else's wife's name into your acknowledgement. So you have to change that. But that will not be part of the plagiarism check when it is done. And generic terms, low standard symbols, standard equations can be avoided. If some of MC square, if you are using, don't need to quote the man Einstein. And some of the India got independence in 1947, whom we are going to quote. These are general knowledge, general terms. So every subject has its own general terms. Fifth law of motion, it's a general. When you are telling neither energy, neither can be created, nor can be destroyed. It's a general, you don't need to tell, but don't write it that I understand elementary cannot be this because of my experiment. It's already told by somebody. But a citation of such general knowledge may not be required. But please check with your supervisor when you are excluding something. So that's all. I think I have done a lot of things. This is what is the definition of UGC now. UGC is not looking at plagiarism as similarity. It is academic dishonesty and breach of ethics. So even if you are copying from a regional language book and translate and put into that, that will be treated as plagiarism as per their notification. So that's all from my side. Wish you all the best. Thank you for listening to me. I have taken another 10 minutes extra.
No problem, sir. Now it's your time. You can take much more. The information is really valuable. And I'm 100% sure that those who are listening and got the point. And this kind of interaction actually is very important, direct to the concerned person. So here one thing is in my mind, that's self-plagiarize. Obviously, that is not true because the people are basically diluting the research. If they are using the self content, that means they are diluting the research. So the problem is, again, the number of publications they require. So that is an issue, right? No problem. But what about to the self-citation? People are using their citations into the article 10 reference.
Okay, sir, I tell you that rather than listening from my mouth, download the important notice of UGC published in April 20th on self-plagiarism. I have the notification with me. If you want, I can show it and share it. Which says self-plagiarism, if you are citing your own article, that article will not be even counted in your H index and all.
Yeah.
And the promotion committee team is asked to look into that. How many of self-cited articles?
Yes.
Okay. And there is a sentence in that. So as a faculty, you should read that. So the API and promotion is calculated if there are so many things which are self. Second paper is my own paper, extension of my own paper. And I have quoted 80%. Committee can tell that. This, but when you cite it, certain question is permitted. So we leave to you. I am not a faculty or I am not a research supervisor as such to give the authenticated statement on it. I only have what is written by UGC. That's all.
It's great, sir. And second more important thing is about to the Sodh Gangotri that I will promote at my personal level also because it is very important and I just came to know about it. Because it is very important, similar to the thesis and other reports. So whether that is a project or synopsis, everything basically should be available online. So people get to know about the whether that is the progress in terms of the research or in terms of the thesis. That data should be available to each and everyone.
Yeah, thank you for that question. This gives another highlight to me. People are scared. People are scared to put it their synopsis with one thing in mind. Mm-hmm. If I put my research, what is going on, research, in Shodh Gangotri, what happened if someone else take and do a PhD? This is what the fear in mind. But in such cases, since you have already published in Shodh Gangotri, you can challenge that other man. Because as per the date of submission in Shodh Gangotri, you become the custodian of the title and the... More important. So it helped, one way it helped the research scholar for your claim.
So one thing I want to ask that when we check the similarity index and there is no similarity index obviously into the abstract and into the conclusion, but sometimes obviously it comes into the methodology and into the introduction in general. So when it counts 10% and this 10% is the contribution of the different sources. So if I talk about to the independent individual sources into the report, so sometimes it is 2%, sometimes is less than 1%, sometimes is greater than 6%. So what is your opinion about it if sometimes that article is of 3000 words and overall percentage is 10%, right, it's fine. But the source from the main source, the first one, and it is near about to 7% for an example. So it is a very critical point, which I think that what is your...
My opinion I will share as a debate topic to everybody. Yeah. You mentioned 3000 words, example. What is 10%? 300 words.
Yeah.
So in 3000 words, if you have 300 words copied, still you are not a plagiarist. 300 words can be used as it is. Still you are not a plagiarist because they are telling 10% is approved. Above 300 words, it comes. 300 words may be not be in one stretch. It will be 1%, one paragraph, second paragraph, 1%. Like that, it attribute up to 30%. 300 words means 30%. So my intention to tell, this 10% is what plagiarism allowed by UGC, but not the similarity. Similarity can be, suppose 17% is there. In 17%, 7% you feel, which is essential and the researcher has quoted already, cited. So as a supervisor, you can mention this can be excluded because researcher has already given credit to the author. And make it below 10%. And you have to give a certificate, convince to the committee. I can only give suggestion, but committee should tell. There are certain things. Suppose Eastman MC square, I find it out at the end of it. See, there is no plagiarism. At the end, I tell, I have found out Eastman MC square with this formula. Will my guide agree it? Will physics agree it? So even if it below 10%, certain things we cannot do at all. 0%. That's why methodology sometimes, no, it cannot be. It depends on the guide and supervisor. And look at other angle. We are talking about science now. Let me talk about literature. A man is doing research on Shakespeare's some drama. He has to take each and every paragraph. So chance of plagiarism is more in such a PhD thesis. He cannot rewrite all the sonnets, no? He cannot mention page number 20 of Shakespeare. You here, unless you take it, how a researcher, we can understand from that. So if he's taking, that can go up to 40%, 30%, etc. But there, the researcher, supervisor should tell that paragraph he had taken, which is shown as plagiarism, is what is his basically only his study part, which is the original contribution of Shakespeare and which has been cited. So it depends on the research topic,
yes,
supervisor and institute. Don't leave it to the research scholar.
No. It's great, sir, overall. And now, if there is one and interested to ask any question related to the plagiarism and research ethics, whatever, the confusion is in mind and want to make clear, any doubt, please, most welcome, and we can provide you this kind of platform.
You can collect all the questions and forward to me.
Yeah, that will be better.
We have been working with research ethics. I am a national coordinator of MOOC, so I am MOOC for research ethics. The examination is going on 26, 1800 people attended this time. Last time also 2000 people attended, and the 4 credit is transferred from one university to other university. Your Chitkara University can definitely look forward to include it in your syllabus. That is 40 hours, not 1 hour, 2 hours. And if they qualify, they get the credit transfer from Central University of Himachal Pradesh to your university, which a university can take a decision to include it. But July 1st, next July only it is starting. July. Right now the examination is on 26. So there are so many ways to interact each other. Otherwise,
okay. Basically, thank you for more from your side. So Gangotri and the original, these things I will promote at my level.
Yeah,
and thank you so much, sir, for your time and for this wonderful information that may be useful definitely for the all the young researcher faculty and especially for the young researchers. So they just know about the real facts and the outcome consequences of any bad practice, malpractices into the research.
Thank you, Dr.
Sushil Kumar,
for giving a chance. I just mentioned, thank you. You promised 80 participants. I can still see 80 participants.
Yeah. But there were 200 registrations, and you can understand now this is the time from 1 to 2. And so yeah. 80 I had promised. Now 80 is okay. I don't want that remain 79. So thank you so much, sir.